Hi, I'm Dr. Sirisha Singh. I'm a cosmetic dermatologist. Today we are going to talk about who are ideal candidates for getting a botulinum toxin job done. Everybody knows botulinum toxin as Botox, but Botox is not a generic name. It is trademarked by Allergan. Botulinum toxin is very useful for people who have dynamic lines. Dynamic lines are those lines which appear when we make facial expression, and when we do not make any facial expression and our face is relaxed, we do not have any lines on our face. In contrast to the dynamic wrinkles are what we call static wrinkles. Static wrinkles or static lines are lines which are present regardless of whether or not we are using our muscles or facial expression. Botulinum toxin works best on people who have dynamic wrinkles. So people from their mid-20s onwards are ideal candidates for getting a botulinum toxin job done. And especially if you have a dynamic wrinkle which is deep when you move your muscles or facial expression. Once people are in their late 50s or early 60s and they have a lot of static lines, yes, botulinum toxins can still work on them. But the amount of reduction in the depth of the lines is only about 50%, and we cannot hope to get rid of the wrinkles and lines completely in people in the late 50s and early 60s and thereafter. So if you were to ask me who is an ideal candidate for getting a botulinum toxin job done, I would say it's people in the late 20s, 30s and 40s. People who have just started to get very deep lines when they use their muscles of the face, or people who have started to develop permanent lines, that is lines which are present even when they do not use their muscles of facial expression. Coming to a few do's and don'ts about getting a botulinum toxin job done. When you see a doctor for a botulinum toxin injection, it is important to lay down your expectations from the botulinum toxin. Discuss your apprehensions with the doctor so the doctor knows exactly which group of muscles to target and exactly which part of the face is to be injected by the doctor. It is also important to discuss with the doctor the degree of improvement that you hope to achieve, because if you want a completely frozen expression, you would have to say that to the doctor, as opposed to if you want a more relaxed appearance without having a completely frozen face. Based upon this, the doctor will decide how many units of botulinum toxin is to be injected into your muscles. You should not be taking any medications which thin the blood for 2 to 3 days before the botulinum toxin injection. If you have any medications that have been prescribed to you by a doctor, you should inform your dermatologist, because some medicines may have to be stopped a couple of days before the botulinum toxin injection. After the botulinum toxin is injected into your muscles of the face, you need to follow the instructions given to you by your doctor, which largely includes sitting upright for 4 hours, contracting the muscles that have been injected for the next 2 hours after the botulinum toxin has been injected. And you will also be advised not to do any weights or any exercises which require you to bend over forwards like yoga for the next day after the botulinum toxin has been done. The day after the botulinum toxin has been done, you can resume all your activities and go back to life as normal. So these were the do's and don'ts that you have to follow before and after you get a botulinum toxin injection done. I hope this has put your mind to rest about any possible side effects and long-term effects of botulinum toxin. If you wish to get any further clarification or you wish to discuss getting a botulinum toxin injection done, feel free to contact me. My contact details are given in the description box below. Thank you.